Hi, I'm Dr. Tasneem from the Department of Obstetrics and Gynecology, Manipal Hospital, Whitefield. Normal menstrual cycle lasts from 21 days to 35 days, with the duration of flow from 2 to 8 days and flow less than 80 ml per cycle. Anything which varies from this normal routine is called as abnormal uterine bleeding. There are many causes for abnormal uterine bleeding. Some of the most common causes are polyps of the cervix and uterus, adenomyosis, leiomyoma, which is commonly known as fibroid uterus, malignancy of the cervix, vagina and the uterus, infections, and coagulopathy, that is blood disorders, which we see usually in young girls. Then we have ovarian dysfunction and endometrial problems. Due to excessive bleeding, patient can be diagnosed with anemia, which they can have breathlessness, tiredness, giddiness, even they can have fainting episodes and shortness of breath. Fibroids can cause pain, and polyps will have foul smelling discharge, and if any malignancy is there, cancerous changes, they can have postcoital bleeding and postmenopausal bleeding. Abnormal uterine bleeding can be diagnosed by a gynecologist, and if you have any excess of bleeding or any abnormality in your menstrual cycle, you have to meet a doctor who will be doing a clinical examination, abdominal examination, per speculum examination and per vaginal examination. Some of the routine blood tests like complete blood count, thyroid function test and a hormonal test will be advised. A pap smear and endometrial biopsy will be done. The most important investigation is transvaginal scanning, which help us to diagnose what the cause of abnormal uterine bleeding, so that we can find out whether there is fibroid, polyps or what is the endometrial thickness by this transvaginal scan. The options for abnormal uterine bleeding are medical and surgical causes, but mainly we have to diagnose and treat the cause. So it depends upon the age of the patient, severity of the bleeding, and whether she is planning for her pregnancy or not, and the type of AUB. Abnormal uterine bleeding can occur at any age, but what we see commonly is during the perimenopausal age, that is above 41 years, they have this problem. To control abnormal uterine bleeding, we have non-hormonal medications like tranexamic acid, mefenamic acid, ethambutolate, and hormonal medications like progesterones, which is given from day 16th of the cycle, and estrogen progesterone combination, which starts from day 5 to day 25, and we have progesterones only, that is levonorgestrel intrauterine devices, and other medications like GnRH and amiloxifen. It can last till the treatment is completed. The important is we have to find the cause and treat the cause. So if the medication does not help and if the scanning says there is an endometrial polyp, we have to go ahead with a hysteroscopic polypectomy. The scan says there is a thick endometrium. The gold standard is hysteroscopic DNC. With this DNC material, we send for histopathology. It helps us to rule out any malignancy and also tells us what is the type of endometrium. The DNC can also stop the abnormal uterine bleeding. The other device which we use is levonorgestrel. So along with the DNC, what we usually combine this levonorgestrel insertion into the uterine cavity, and we have found the incidence of blood loss has improved very much. Almost 80 to 90% of the bleeding is reduced. And this levonorgestrel can be used as a contraceptive and it can be kept for 5 years. The other options are endometrial ablation, which can be done. If all these methods fail, then the last resort is hysterectomy. we have observed in most of the patients that it has given this liver nodule gestrel introducing into the uterine cavity along with the DNC has given us very good result, and it reduces the blood flow by 90%. Abnormal uterine bleeding, if it is excessive, this can lead to severe anemia, which is force the patient to go ahead with a blood transfusion. If the DNC report comes as complex hyperplasia and there are increased incidence for malignancy, fibroids can go ahead with the degenerative changes and cause severe pain. To a little extent, abnormal uterine bleeding can be controlled if the person has a balanced and healthy diet and with good regular exercise. This prevents obesity, which helps to control the hormonal imbalance. To 90% of the abnormal uterine bleeding will cure after the treatment. If all the medical procedures fail, only then we have to plan for hysterectomy.